So the next problem is, if a planet were suddenly stopped in its orbit, supposed to be circular, prove that it will fall into the sun in a time which is equal to square root of 2 by 8 times of the time period of revolution. So let us say this is the circular motion of the particle. So this is the center, and from here to here it is the radius r. Okay. So now the planet is removing around a circle of r. So let us say the planet is stopped here. So now it is the now it is going to fall into the sun, which is at the origin O. So according to the Kepler's third law, the period of revolution is directly proportional to the square of the radius. So square of the time period is directly proportional to the cube of the radius. So now let us say this planet is suddenly stopped here. Okay, so when the planet is suddenly stopped here, it will move into the sun because due to the attractive force. So let us say the particle is moving in a elliptical orbit having radius, which is, let us suppose, r dash, and here r dash equal to r by 2. Okay, so now the planet is moving, now the planet has stopped. Now the planet has stopped and it is moving in an elliptical orbit. Towards the sun, which is having radius. R dash, that is equal to r by 2. So according to the Kepler's third law, T2 is square of the time period, T2 square is directly proportional to the r dash cube. So T2 square is directly proportional to the r by 2 whole cube. So when the particle suddenly stops here, so it will fall into the sun. Now the particle does not move directly towards the sun, it will move in an elliptical orbit because of the central force. Okay, so now we bring this, let us say this is equation 1 and this is the equation 2. So T2 square divided by T1 square is directly so equal to r by 2 whole cube divided by r cube, that is equal to 1 by 2 whole cube. So that is equal to 1 by to power 3, and T2 square equal to T1 square root of 1 by 8. So T2 equal to T1 into 1 by 8 whole power 1 by 2. T1 is the time period, that is the period of revolution of the orbit when it is moving in the circular motion. So and T2 is the time period to move in the circular motion within the radius r dash, that is equal to r by 2. But now we have to, according to the formula, so when the particle suddenly stops here, we need to calculate only the time period which is moving from here to the sun. So this is equal to the half of the time period that is required to move in the complete orbit. So the time taken by the planet is equal to the half of the time period to reach the sun. So that is equal to 1/8 whole power 1/2, half of the time it's time period. So 1/2 into square root of 2, that is equal to square root of 2 divided by 8 times the time period.